Hey YouTube, how's it going? Repugnant Man here, coming at you with a Pokemon theory slash conspiracy video. Yes, Queen! Yes, Queen! Today we're going to be covering one of my favorite evolution lines, Yamask and Cofagrigus. Now, this is one of my favorite Pokemon. It's one of the coolest design Pokemon, has one of the coolest shiny forms. But more importantly, if you look at the lore behind this Pokemon, you'll find out that it was one of the only Pokemon that actually used to be human. Gengar is another Pokemon that actually used to be human as well. So if we take a closer look at the Pokedex entry of Yamask and Cofagrigus, in Pokemon Black we see that it states, each of them, being Yamask, carries a mask that used to be its face when it was human. Sometimes they look at it and cry. Now the Pokemon White Pokedex entry states, these Pokemon arose from the spirits of people interred in graves in past ages. Each retains memories of its former life. To truly understand this magnificent theory, one must analyze the geography of the Unova region. I mean, just looking at it, it looks pretty normal. But according to director Junichi Masuda, the Unova region is based on New York City. When examining photos, it becomes evident that all the piers found throughout Castalia City bear a striking resemblance to the piers in Lower Manhattan. More resemblances can be seen with the Sky Arrow Bridge being in the same location as the Brooklyn Bridge. And then there is of course the Liberty Garden, which is directly inspired by Liberty Island, where the Statue of Liberty is located. The point that I'm getting at is that Game Freak did something very intriguing when they chose the geolocation of the Relic Castle. As you can see, this place is a desert wasteland. This is important to our tale, because the Relic Castle is the only place in the entire game where you can find Yamask. Now, guess which New York location correlates with the ruins of the Relic Castle. You guessed it, it's Ground Zero. Ground Zero, for those of you who don't know, is the location of the terrorist attack that occurred on 9/11. But wait a second, what does this mean for our little buddy Yamask? Who is Yamask? Wait a second. Who's driving the car? It's unsubstantiated theory time. So let's get our facts straight. The Pokemon Company made a ghost-type Pokemon that used to be a human and put it in the location of Ground Zero. That's pretty sketchy. And if you don't think that that's evidence enough, there's more. According to a Lucanosa Town legend, a large meteor came down from the sky containing a terrifying Pokemon. So this meteor and this Pokemon was later confirmed to be Kyurem. It is said that at night, the monster would appear in the town along with the cold winds and take away humans and Pokemon to eat them. And what's even more disturbing is guess how tall Kyurem, or this meteor, is. It's 9 feet. And 10 inches tall, which can basically be rounded up to 9 feet 11 inches tall. I mean, what the heck, Pokemon? Now, it is never stated where this meteor exactly landed. I speculate that it is in the region of the Relic Castle. So that really explains the destruction and just desolate area that the Relic Castle is. This information, coupled with the geolocation of Yamask, makes me believe that Yamask is a victim of 9/11. I mean, think about it. Why does it look at his mask and cry? Maybe it's because it knows that its death was used to fuel the false and endless wars that preceded it. That's it, guys. That's my ridiculous Yamask conspiracy theory video. If you liked it, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe. I'm going to be making tons of content for Pokemon Sword and Shield. It's going to be freaking awesome. I'm Repugnant Man. Remember to stay poignant. YOLO.